Hello, everyone. Welcome back to American Truck Simulator. My name is Jeff Fabiano. Today, we're going to check out a new mod that I did get. It came down to two trucks for this single player profile. It was either going to be the International 9800i or 9900i, that's what it is, which is a fantastic truck, or the new Freightliner Classic XL version 2 that came out. That is absolutely awesome, what you see right here. It's completely bone stock. We're going to do a lot of modifications to it to make it our own, but it was between those two trucks, and I chose this one. This is the first truck we ever used in the series, so I figured it'd be pretty cool to go back to it and see how far along it has come. So with that said, we are here at the Peterbilt, the Kenworth dealership, I think, in LA. Are we in LA? No, we're in Phoenix. I'm thinking of where I was in my live stream. Man, oh man. Let's hit enter and let's go into the upgrade shop, shall we? All right, let's start off here. I'm thinking we're just going to roll with a flat top on this. Since we did the conventional, you can do an XL raised roof on it. We're going to go to flat top since I have never used that on the Freightliner XL, so I figured we would do that. This comes with some awesome, awesome engine sounds. Detroit Diesel series, you can do a Cat or you can do a... where's the other one? No, it's just Cat or Detroit Diesel. 425 is good, but I think we want a little extra power under the hood, so we're going with 515. Remember that we don't have infinite amounts of money, so I've got to keep that in mind as well. Transmission-wise, got to have my 18 speed. I have to. Interior-wise, this is where it can get really cool. You can do a custom shifter for $5,000, and it brings it up. Now, what that means is you can customize that shifter, which you will see a little bit later on here. Let's go to the paint job. I do want to get a paint job on this, and I was looking at a lot of the Classic XLs that are actually on the road, and I chose I decided I want to go with a blue, but I want to go with like a galaxy blue, which I think it's called Blue Smurf. Is it Blue Smurf or is it Blue Storm? No, it's Blue Smurf. Yeah, we're going to go with Blue Smurf. I think that'll be a really cool color. Something a little bit different. Or was it Blue Sweet? I think it's Blue Sweet, not Blue Smurf. Smurf's got a little more galaxy kind of like cyan happening there. But Blue Sweet. Let's go with Smurf. I kind of like it. Yeah, I'm feeling the Smurf. Let's go into accessories. This is where you can make the truck pretty much what you want it to be. And I do want to get rid of this. This original one visor kind of looks weird on that. So you can go with this one or you can go with the classic. You know, that thing looks absolutely mean. It's way too much. It's just way too much. I think we're going to go with the classic custom on this particular truck. Or we can just stay with the classic visor. And be able to actually see out of our truck, but I think we'll go with that for now. And yeah, look at all these options you have. We can go down here to the bumper. You can do a stock bumper chrome, a custom bumper, or a moose bumper. And we're gonna do a moose bumper on it. We normally never have a huge ram bar on the front, so I wanted to change it up this time. And with that said, we're gonna do that bug deflector. I just want a plastic one for now. We have here is the different hood things you can do. You do a convoy duck if you'd like, or so on and so forth. I'm going to keep it kind of stock like that. Here are the different badges you can do. You can do like the classic badges on it, which is actually really neat that they added all these different things to it. I really do like it. I'm going to keep it off for now. And here's the different grills. Got a bunch of different grills we can do. I really love this. You see that on the highways all the time. It's a very classic look with the teeth. I think we're gonna go with the teeth on that one. Yeah, yes we are. There's the bull bar. You can add lights to it if you'd want, so we can do that later down the road. Right now, you know, we just don't have all the money in the world. We're gonna be careful with that. Flames would put the little Kenworth logo on the side for $100. Why not, you know? Let's be proud Freightliner owners. We're not gonna do the hood mirrors on this one for now. Maybe later down the road. Let's see here. I want lights. Yes, more the merrier when it comes to lights. I do like a lot of lights on my trucks. Here are some options out here for plastic trim or chrome trim. For now, you know, we're starting out with nothing, so you can do the same thing with the door handles, and I'll show you what that is like when we're inside the actual cab and all the different things we can do as far as the dashboard goes. So moving down the back, we can do aluminum, painted, or chrome. And I think we're just going to roll with the chrome. I like the chrome on that one a lot. It's a little expensive, but I think we're going to be okay. And here's the back. We can do different, pieces there, but you can also make this a custom back if you want. So you can change your mud flaps however you want to. But there is an option to actually change it. It's right here. Yep, stock rear setup is what it's chosen on right now. And we can go to a rear setup. And I like that rear setup on that. That looks really cool like that. So we're going to roll with that. And like I said, we're saving money because we're going to do some fun stuff inside the truck to start off with. Tires wise, let's go with some Goodyears on this baby. Let's slap some Goodyears. We have some FuelMax 315s there, actually. 315 is a pretty fat tire for that truck. It kind of reminds me of a logging truck almost. Let's go with a 295-80. I like the 295s on this thing. And same thing for this. Let's do a 295. I love this little search thing you can do here. It really helps you find the tires that you want. 295 for you, a 295-80 as well. There we go. So we're all Goodyeared up. As far as the wheels go, let's just go with the chrome. I like the look of the chrome on these things. I do. Let's do the same thing for this guy right here. Just keep the standard with the chrome on it. We're not going all out. So now that we saved a little bit of money on the outside, because you can do a lot of stuff up here, you know, like we can get roof add-ons. You can get roof lights. Actually, let's do the roof lights. We should do the roof lights on the flat top. That's kind of a European thing for all those lights. I'm not going to do that. You can do an interior light. Why not? And let's go inside and see all the different things you can do to this thing. It's pretty amazing, actually. We've got right here, you can do a GPS or a tablet. We're going to go with GPS. We have a hood mirror we could use. You can change, you know, you put a nameplate on there. I don't really like those. Steering wheels, here's the stock one. You have Combo Classic, Combo FLD, Combo Leather, so on and so forth. Mahogany, because I'm going to make this a mahogany tricked out looking interior on this thing. So let's do that. Let's keep that. These are the different ones you can do. You can do toned down chrome trim. You can change all the trim on all this stuff. It's really, really cool. Wide chrome trim, so on and so forth. Plastic. We're going to keep plastic on it for right now. Or actually, they had toned down chrome trim already on there, so we'll just leave it as it was. It's the bumper stuff. Here you go. You can put anything you want in there. I love Coca-Cola. I'm going to put that in there. We've got a parrot. You can put a parrot in here. Right like that. Which is kind of a cool thing. I'm not going to put it in there for now, but really neat thing you can do. Here's a classic. You can do the FLD series dash or the mahogany. We're going to go with mahogany in here. Make it really interesting. Actually, I like the FLD series a lot. So on this guy, can we get an FLD series? Like, well, let's see what it looks like. No. Yeah, FLD. I love that FLD look. That is nice. All right, that's good. That's good. You can even do the... little switch covers, which is really cool. We're going to keep it on plastic for now since we already own it. And here's what I'm talking about. You can change all of this. You can do a splitter chrome, an 18 speed, a 13 speed, and a 10 speed. We're going to do 18 speed since we, you know, that's what we have. But you can change this as well. Mahogany, plastic, shift, chrome covered even, you name it. I mean, a lot of stuff you can do. We're going to try to make this match FLD series. There we go. I love that look. And the top, you can even do that as well. FLD series, make it nice. Like that, medallion gears, mahogany. You can do, like, again, FLD if you want. I like the medallion, though. I like to see what gears we're in. And then these are the options for this. Again, you can change chrome or plastic around the edges of everything. Really neat stuff. Dashboard options. Not really sure what that's all entails. You can add things to that as well. You can do a dash cam. Why not? And what do we have over here? Co-driver plate. All right. Up here, we've got, some decorations we can do. This is really cool. You can put these little stupid things if you like them. Or no, this isn't what I was thinking it was going to be. No. I don't like the curtains. That's like a European thing. I'm pretty sure. I'll show you what I'm talking about. It's this right here. Yeah. You can change out your air fresheners. Isn't that amazing? And with that said, they actually are animated. They move around. Like, that is really, really cool. All right, that's good to go. What do we have over here? That's all that stuff. Here's the back of the... Yep, it's looking pretty good. I like the way it's looking so far. You know, like I said, we're going to spend more money on it eventually down the road. But until then, I'm pretty happy with everything we've got here. Any more options there? Doesn't seem like we do. I think we pretty much nailed it. Let's hit confirm order. 32 grand we're paying for this thing. Oh, but it does look pretty badass. One more thing I do want to upgrade on it is the stacks. Definitely got to change the stacks on it. Oh, you can change the interior out on it. Look at this. New black interior, blue interior, so on and so forth. I think we're going to go with the black interior. I like the black. I do like the black. Oh, yeah, we can do a headache rack on the back. That looks pretty awesome. I like that a lot. Where are the stacks? There's got to be an option for stacks. There usually is. Here they all are. Exhausts. Yes, this is what we wanted to look at. And you got to look at it from the front whenever you put these things on. I want some big... Oh, perfect. Perfect. Straight pipes right out the side like that for this flat top. I don't even have to look anymore. That's what I want. That is what I want. All right. Without further ado, let's go ahead and try to find ourselves a run around here so we can check out the truck. All right. We are in the cab of our truck. Let's fire it up for the first time. Oh, yeah. I love the sound of that. Oh, man. Look at this interior. Really nice. Really nice stuff. All right. Let's get rolling to pick up our... I think we're going to go pick up some wood shavings, and we're going to run those down to, I believe, Camp Verde is going to be what we're going to do today for this run. I like the placement of the GPS. It's really nice. Maybe making a left out of here. And we'll... do a short little run here in the truck to see what it's all about. I'm very, very excited about doing this. And as you can see, the air freshener is already moving around up there. It even works with the, when you hit the brakes, like it really will go flopping around. Make her right out of here. All right, buddy, you turning here? Yep. I guess he's not going to go, so we're going to go instead. Man, this thing's got a little bit of power under the hood. Oop. Didn't get into gear there. Listen to that. That sounds so nice. That Jake brake is good. Let's make a left here. Look at that little thing bouncing around. It's so neat. It's just the little things like that that make it really cool. And the little squeaks and all the different sounds it makes. Not bad at all. I do have to skip gears a lot more in this truck than I'm used to. But that's because we're bobtailing. And we got that extra horsepower as well. So that'll be pretty cool. Man, this upcoming week, I will be in Boston for PAX. Isn't that crazy? It did not take long at all for that to come. All right, dude, are you going? Oh, they don't have a stop. Okay, that makes sense. We're going to have to wait for traffic a little bit here. But yeah, it's pretty insane that that's already happening. Come on, buddy. So, yeah, let me know if you're going to be in Boston, if you planned on going to PAX, because I will be there, and I would love to meet up with people if they're going to go as well. Ooh, I'm not speeding, mister. We're in Phoenix, Arizona still. That was Phoenix Police Department there. Oh, let's get on the highway. We're going to have to see just how fast this baby will go. Oh, yeah, it's got some power under the hood. Looks good to me. There's an 8 high. Nice, man. Yes. We had to get those big pipes with that, you know, that kind of Jake brake sound. We're getting off right up here to pick up the load. So we'll just stay right here behind this Grand Marquis station wagon. Keep an eye on everybody behind us. We're good. We're all good. Slid on here. Don't even have to really Jake brake down this at all. You can just kind of use nothing but downshifting to slow you down. It works out really nice. Left here. Come on, buddy, go. There you go, just like that. And go before that bus gets here. Yeah, this thing's got some power in it. It's going to be a lot nicer once I have a trailer on the back. That's for sure. 33 here, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, we're making a right up here. So let's go ahead and get in this lane. But I chose the short run for a reason, so we can, not take a day and a half to get somewhere. So that will be nice. But, yep, I'll see you guys when we get to the yard. All right, looks like we're picking up here at the cargo area. Look at these DC-10s out here. Isn't that awesome? That looks amazing. What does that say? Starliban Cargo. What the hell is Starliban Cargo? I like how the little cargo door open on the DC-10 on that left side there. That might be an MD-11. I can't see if they have winglets or not. Nope, looks like a DC-10 to me. Looks like a Dash 30. We'll make a left into here and pick up. It's supposed to be a trailer full of, I believe, wood chips. I think. I don't know why it's at this particular dock in air cargo, but hey, what do I know? What do I know? Phoenix Freight and Transport Company. All right. That's probably why. Let's see what they have in store for us. Well, you're never going to believe this. We got to the load and it expired. So we had to get a new load and we're going to pick this thing up. I'm not sure where we're exactly going as it was kind of a last minute decision there. Picking up Walmart, taking a good old Walmart trailer somewhere. Gotta love that. Right here on the right. Hopefully this one won't be expired when we pull in. gotta love that. The game's like, nope, you want a daytime run, you're not gonna get it. We're gonna throw nighttime on you no matter how hard we try. All right, there we go. Freight market. I think the one we're taking is this one. We're going to Yuma. That's what it is. Yep. So we'll go ahead and take this job. Let's go ahead and pull up and grab it. This mod is actually pretty good with the, it is good with the advanced coupling. So that's pretty cool. You can use that with this version. I'm not on the newest, or the latest and greatest beta because this truck is not compatible with the new beta. I'm pretty sure from what I did read other people say. So that's the reason why I didn't. It's got a custom backup sound, which I think is a lot more manageable to listen to than the default one. You know, default beep, beep, beep. All right, we're picking up this. That looks like a reefer trailer. Nope, we did get it. Nice. Beautiful. There she is, all set up. I love the look of that flat top. It is such a good looking truck, man. I do like it a lot. All right, let's do a tug test. We'll go release our parking brake. Put this thing in low, low. We'll hold the trailer brake down and we're good to go. Fantastic. Put her in one low and let's get on out of here. We're already behind schedule, but I think we'll be A-okay. Since the highway is right there anyway, it won't be a problem for us at all. I don't believe so. Good on fuel. Listen how smooth that engine sounds. That thing sounds so nice. Here is the freeway entrance. We made it. Yeah. I know you're tired, dude. Just suck it up. Just suck it up a little bit. Watch ourselves getting on the highway here. You know how menacing the traffic can be. We're all good. That's a miracle. There's 8 low, and then we can go into 8 high and sip gas. Because we are technically in, no, we're not in California, we're in Arizona. So actually, we're good to go a little bit faster than 55. So that's always nice. Alright, got my thumbnail, and I turned off fatigue simulation, so we don't have to listen to that guy bitching moaning at us about him wanting to go to sleep. It's not that long of a run, buddy. You can do it. I have faith in you. Still showing a 55 mile an hour zone through here, though. And yes, it is. Damn it. There it is. Now it's in 65. Should have known better. I was just in a 55 mile an hour zone right there. But to be honest, I was out of my element. I was taking a screenshot and all that good stuff. So, well. I'm not going to beat myself up over it too much. Oh, look at that. There's no water there. It looks like you're on a bridge over water, but nope. Not the case. Not the case today, but with the new beta that came out for America Truck Sim, I know now you can get those fast passes or whatever they're called, for you to go by the way station and stuff. So they are still actively working on the components of the game, and that's actually a really, really neat thing. Okay, we're slowing down here, people. Into one lane. Yep, insta one lane. Come on, come on. Good God. Sorry about that, dude. Didn't realize that that was ending. That was my bad. All right, let me get back into my zone here. I'm way out of my element here. 35 mile an hour zone, but yeah, it's good to see them working on the game still. You know, not just the add-on states, but the actual meat and potatoes of the game. Well, I'd love to see more trucks, and I know that's got to be a whole licensing issue that they've been running into. The reason why we haven't seen any more of those. Because I think SES should have a Freightliner Classic like this by now. But, you know what? I'm happy with what we have. And the modding scene is just absolutely awesome and strong in this game, so I can't complain at all. It's like, here's the highway we're going to be getting on up here. I don't know why I thought that highway we got on was going to be like the one that takes us directly to the west, but this is the one. Hopefully now we can actually wind this baby up, get some speed out of it. Yeah, 75 mile an hour zone. And that car actually let us on the highway. Holy crap. Such a smooth motor. Love that. Got a helicopter up there? Yep, that's a helicopter. Up there. I don't know what he's doing. He's just kind of circling, isn't he? Yeah, he is. This guy is like, he's tailgating that truck, but he's going so slow doing it. Come on, people. What are we going to do, 50 miles an hour through here? Apparently, that's what they want to do. Come on. Yeah, there you go. I'm going to have to get around this dude, too, after this truck. After that SUV. There we go. Of course, now that guy speeds up. That's about how it works in this game. With the AI, they're going really slow, and then they speed up. By the way, this is the first time that I've recorded with the 1080 in America Truck Sim. And my God, does it look good. I can turn up the scaling even more, but I get, like, I'm at 300. If I turn the scaling up to 400, it gets a little choppy on the frame rates in the big city, so I'll just keep it as it is. Man, we're up to like 80 miles an hour, no problem with this engine. And it's such a quiet sounding engine, it's very peaceful. And it's not an annoying whistle, it's a very realistic sounding, smooth one. So whoever did the sounds of this mod, holy crap, they're good. What time is it right now? Oh, we can hit I to look at the time. If we hit the I key, we can go through our different stuff here. There it is, 5:15 p.m. 95 degrees out. Oh, I love the sound of that Jake brake. It just sounds like you're driving a truck with huge stacks on it, you know? Let's go to the outside view and listen to that. That just sounds so good. Listen to that. It's so good. Oh man, that sounds so good. No, we're not getting off here. Even though it tells us to. All right, dude, we cannot stick in this lane forever. They're just going so damn slow. I always get comments asking me how I get real smooth head tracking in here. And a lot of people think I'm in VR. I wish that was the case, but I am using TrackIR version 5. And I don't have the Pro, so it's not the LED lights or anything. It's just a little clip that goes on your hat. And then there's a camera that sits on top of your monitor. And you just move your head around freely as if you're looking. It's actually really nice, and I absolutely could not do an episode without it. I mean, you can, but it's just not the same. Why are we braking going uphill? That's a new one for me, people. That is a new one for me. Going to 7 high here. I'm going to get around these dudes. Saya, Saya, Saya. Saya, you're making me Saya. Come on. Let's get over. car doesn't want to let us over. No, of course. Nobody does. Here we go. That guy let us over. We'll say thank you to him for that reason. Went to 8 low. Whoa, dude! First time I get to hear the horn. Boy, he just really came right over into our lane. You jackass. Well, there's Yuma, so we're getting off up here anyway, so oh well. Now we gotta try to get back over, and that's gonna be a nightmare and a half. Come on, buddy. You gonna let us over? Nope. Shouldn't. Come on. I'm coming over, dude. Yeah, you can slam the brakes. I'm trying to get over for like three cars. He's like, nope, I'm not letting you over. I'm gonna be a dick. I'm like, well, thanks, man. Appreciate it. We appreciate you. Oh, we have the Jake brake all the way down this hill. Watch. Oh, yeah. That sounds good. Good Lord. That sounds nice. Got a left turn here. That looks like a nice desert sun. The S-Gate weather mod just never fails me. I love the look of it. All right, buddy. Coming this way. Our little air freshener still hanging around, swinging. I don't know how you turn the interior light on. Remember, we did get an interior light. I wonder if it comes on with the headlights. Nope, doesn't seem like it does. But that's okay, nonetheless. We'll just pull in right here. Yep, we're going right over there. I'm not sure where the hell we're dropping, though. That's the real question here. Is it what I think it is? It looks like it's one of those marts. Yep. It's exactly what I thought it was going to be. Okay, well. Which one, though? That's the real question, is which one is it going to be? All right, let's go ahead and pull in here. All the way. Then we'll just back the trailer in. Right around that corner. Try not to hit any cars in the process. That's the real challenge of this. Just try not to hit any cars while doing this. Because you can see how close we gotta get to these cars here on the side. Let's try not to smash into them though. Nice and straight here, just right up next to them. Yeah, it's working. It's working for us. We're turning with it. Gotta wash the nose so we don't hit the... Oh, we're right up on that little Fiesta there. We're okay. If we can just pull out and get into that little open spot there, we'll be good to go. There's a car right there, but we'll be okay after that. Ooh, we cut it way too hard. Let's do it a little bit better than that. I didn't think we had to cut it that hard, but apparently we did. So we'll just go nice and easy here with it. So we don't have to get so close to the cars, you know? Just kind of turn with the trailer instead. There we go, like that. And then once we get into that hole right after this car, we'll pretty much golden. Yeah, that worked out real nice for us. Now we can pull up into here. Hopefully not hit this car right here. I don't trust it. Back up a little bit more. Get in this hole. There we go. Fantastic. Just like that. And then we turn with it. And let's see which one it is. Oh, we hit the fucking car over there. Shit. Yep, sorry about it, man. God, I forgot about that car for 1 second. Oh. This has not been our run, man. It's not been a good run for us today. I don't know if it's going to be the one right next to the wall or not. But if it is, I'm cutting it just in case. Actually, we should probably just drive back here and check out and see which one it is, because I don't know. I don't know myself. Is it the one next to the wall? Yes, it is. Okay, well, there you go. Now we know. After I hit that damn car over all of it. Oh, man. Yeah, I'm just way off my game today for this. Sorry about that. If you come here for accurate driving, you're not getting it today. It's not happening. Let's sneak it right by this wall here. If possible. little bit earlier there. There we go. We're good. Now we can cut it. We'll have to, you know, pull up, of course, but let's turn with it here. Would have been good, but I didn't cut it hard enough. We went to the dock next to it, but that's okay. We can back it in, pull it up, and then back it in from the left side. Well, at least we didn't have to drive through the night. That's a win in my book. There we go. We'll take it. Whew. We will take that. Pull that parking brake out. Have a look here. And that's why we have that huge bumper on it. Sorry about you, buddy. Let's go ahead and undo this. Decouple. And see where we end up. 222 miles. Excellent. We didn't even get a damage penalty or anything. Miracle, I tell you. Getting closer to that level 14. Still 11-13, though, regardless. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is going to do it for us on this one. Thank you for stopping by and watching some American Truck Simulator. I'll see you in the next one. Take care.